Hi, this is Anil from Learning Lad, and welcome to another video on file handling using C programming language. In this video, we will talk about the ferror, feof, and clearerr functions. Here, what I have done is I have written a very simple C program. I have included the stdio.h standard header file. It provides us access to all these functions that I have mentioned. For example, fopen, ferror, all these functions are defined in this stdio.h header file. When we include that to our program, we get access to them. And then we have the main function in here, and this is the entry point of our program. In this main function, what we have done is we have created a pointer called as fp, and it is of type file. This file is a type defined structure which is used when we work with the files. It contains some information about the file that we are working with. Here in this tutorial, we will mainly be talking about two particular information. One is called as the end of file flag or indicator, and the second one is called as the error flag or error indicator. The end of file flag or the EOF flag is set when a read operation which is performed on the file tries to go past the last character present in the file. And then the error flag or error indicator is set when some error occurs while performing the file operation. We're going to be using these two flags which are set in this file structure. So here what we have done is we have opened a file called as input.txt using the file opening mode R. And if I open up the project here, then I have a folder called as file handling, and in this folder I have this ferror.c, which is the source code that we are seeing here, and then in this folder I have input.txt. So what we are doing here is we are trying to open this input.txt, which contains this text, subscribe and hype. If you like this video, this is the text that I have here, and then we are checking whether the file has been opened successfully or not. If the fp pointer contains null, it means there was some issue while opening the file, and we are displaying that issue to the screen using the perror function. So this perror function allows us to display our message along with the reason for the error. For example, if I use only printf in here, then I can only specify my message. But with this perror, I can specify my message, and also it will display the reason for the error. For example, here maybe the fopen function fails to open the file because the file is not there. So this perror will display fopen, which is the message that I have given, and then the reason why it was unable to open the file. And after that, if the file is not opened, then we are terminating the program. We are returning a value of 1 here. Now after that, if the file has been opened successfully, then what we are doing is we are reading the contents of the file character by character by using the fgetc function. I have created an integer variable called as ch. Then I'm using this fgetc function and I'm reading one character at a time from the file, and then I'm storing that in this ch variable. I have already made a video about this fgetc function. What it does is it reads one character at a time from the file. It also increments our position in the file. So the position information is stored in this file structure. So after reading a particular character, it will increment our position in the file automatically. Now, if we talk about the syntax of this fgetc function, you know, it looks like this. So we have to provide a file pointer and it will return an integer value. Now, if we talk about the fgetc function's return value, then there are two possible values. One is the numeric code, which will represent the character depending on the encoding standard, which this function has successfully read from the file. The second one is the EOF character. Now this EOF character is returned in two scenarios. One is while performing the read operation on the file, if any error occurs in the middle, then it will return EOF or end of file character. The second scenario is the fgetc function has read all the contents of the file and there is nothing left in the file to read. In that scenario also, this function returns EOF character. Now here with this while loop, what we are doing is we are using this function to read single character at a time, and we are continuously doing that until we get EOF from this fgetc function. So in two scenarios, we get EOF, as I said before. one if any error occurs, or there is nothing left in the file to read. We have read everything from the file. In that case, this while loop terminates. Otherwise, we are displaying whatever the character that we have read from the file. Now after that, we are closing this file. Now here, quickly, I will run this program. And when I do that, we get the output subscribe and hype if you like this video. This is the content of this input.txt. But here, after this while loop, how I can programmatically say that we have read everything from the file? Because we know that this loop has been terminated because we get eof or end of file character from this fgetc function. You know, it can happen maybe because of the error, or maybe we have read everything from the file. So how we can say that we have read everything from the file and this eof that we have received from this fgetc is not because of some error? In order to say that, we can use a function called as feof. Now, if you talk about the syntax of this particular function, the name is feof, and we have to provide the file pointer, and it will return zero or non-zero value. Now here, remember, we are providing the file pointer, which will point to a structure of type file. If you remember, I said that this structure contains some information or flags. One of them is whether we have reached the end of the file, or eof flag. This flag is set to true when a read operation tries to go past the last character present in the file. For example, in this input.txt, if we have read everything from the file and if there is nothing left in the file to read, then this eof flag is set. This feof function will check for that flag which is present in the structure pointed by this file pointer. Now this function returns zero if we have not reached the end of the file. If we have reached the end of the file, or if the eof flag is set in the structure pointed by this file pointer, then it will return a non-zero value. In C language, zero is considered as false, non-zero value is considered as true. And in this scenario, in this program, we will use this function in order to check whether this loop stopped because there is nothing left in the file to read. So in order to check that, we will use the if conditional statement, and here we will use the feof function. So here I have to provide the file pointer. So if it is a non-zero value, which will be considered as true, then we will use a printf function and we will say complete file is read. Now here, before the message, I will insert a new line, and then if I run this program, we will get subscribe and hype if you like the video, that is the content of the file, and then we get complete file is read. Now we know that we have read everything from the file. Now the next thing that I want to show you here is, what if we have only two characters in this file? For example, I will have S and U, and then I will get rid of this while loop for the time being, and then we will read from the file. So it will be fgetc, and here I have to provide the file pointer. So what it does is, it will read one character from the file, and after that, what we do is, we will use the putchar function, and we will display the character that we have read on the screen. So now if you look at this file, we have only two characters, and we are reading only one character from the file. So if I save this program and if I run this, what happens is, we get the output as S, and it will not say complete file is read because we have read only one character from the file and we have not gone past the last character present in the file. So in order to do that, what I will do is, I will copy this and I will paste it one more time. So now what we are doing is, we are reading two characters from this file. So if I save this program, then what happens is, we get su, and still we don't get the message stating that complete file is read. That's because the eof flag in this file stream is not set, because we have not gone past the last character present in this file. Yes, we have read the last character, but we have not gone past that. So in order to go past that, what I will do is I will use this function again. So this time, you know, we will go past the last character present in the file. So if I run this now, we get yes, you, and then some non-printable character, and then it says complete file is read. So what happened here is, in this first call, the fgetc function returns the first character, it increments our position in the file, then the second character is read, it increments our position in the file, and then when we go here and we try to read the character and there is nothing left in the file to read, and that's why the fgetc function returns eof or end of the file character, and the eof flag on this file stream is set to true, and this putchar function tries to display the eof character, which is a non-printable character, and that's why we get that question mark or, you know, something like that. And then we are checking whether the eof flag is set on this file stream. Yes, because we have gone past the last character present in the file, and that's why, you know, this message is displayed. So now let's go back to the previous code that we had, and let's change the message to complete message. Now the next thing is, how do we know whether this loop was terminated because of some error? While performing the operation on the file, some error occurs, and you know, the fgetc function returns the eof character. How we can check for that? For that, we have a function available, and it is called as the ferror function. Now if you look at this function, then the name is ferror. We have to provide the file pointer, and it will return an integer value. If the error flag is set in the file structure, it will return a non-zero value, otherwise it will return zero. So if you get a return value of zero, then it means that no error has occurred. Now again, the file structure contains information about the file stream, and one of the information is error flag. It is set to true when some error occurs while performing the operations on the file. Here, for the example purpose, I'm using fgetc function. You can use any other standard library function which will work on the file, and all these eof flag, error flag, all these things are same. So if any error occurs while performing the operation on the file, the error flag is set on the file stream, and this function is used to check for that. So how we can use that? Again, we will use the if conditional statement, and here we will use this ferror. And again, if you remember, in C language, zero is considered as false, non-zero value is considered as true. For this function, I have to provide the file pointer. So if this function returns a value of zero, then it means that no error has occurred. If it returns a non-zero value, then it means some error has occurred. So non-zero value means true, and this if block will be executed. And then here I will use the printf function, and then I will say error occurred while reading from the file. So here in this example, we are reading from the file. That's why I'm specifying the message like this. Now, one thing that we have to remember is this ferror function only tells us whether some error has occurred or not. It will not tell you what type of error occurred, or it will not tell you the reason for the error. Now, if I save this program and if I run this, then you can see the content of the file, and then it says complete file is read. Now here, no error has occurred. That's why this message is not displayed. Now, in order to display this message, what I will do is I will change the file opening mode to W. So we are opening the file here in writing mode, but we are trying to read from the file. So it will create an error. Now, if I run this program, then we get error occurred while reading from the file. So here what happened is we opened the file in writing mode, but when this fgetc function tries to read from the file, you know, we can't do that. And that's why the structure pointed by this file pointer will have the error flag, and it will be set to true. And this fgetc function will return eof, because, you know, when the error occurs, it returns eof. And then this end of the file flag is not set because we have not reached the end of the file. So this will not be executed, but this will be executed because error flag is set in this file stream. Okay. Now, next thing that I want to talk about here is a function called as clearerr, which is used to clear the errors on the file stream. It will clear the end of file flag and it will clear the error flag on the file stream. So here, just to demonstrate that, what I will do is I will paste this message two times. So what we're doing is we are checking the error flag twice here and we're displaying the message. So before the message, I will insert a new line, you know, just to make it pretty. And then I will run this program. Nothing special happens. We get error occurred while reading from the file twice here. Why? Because we are checking this two times. Now, what we do is we use a function called as clearerr. Now, if you look at the syntax of this, name is clearerr. We have to provide the file pointer. What it does is it resets the error flags. So we will use this function. So here, what I will do is after checking this error flag, I will clear that by using the clearerr. And I just have to provide the file pointer pointed by this FP. And now if I run this program, what happens is, you know, it will display this error message only once. Why? Because at this particular time period, the error flag on this file stream is set. But after this clearerr, that error flag will be reset. So if I run this, you guys can see we get only one error message here. So this clearerr function, it will reset the error flag and also it will reset the end of file flag. So this is it guys for this particular video. If you guys have any doubt, then post your doubt in the comment section. If you like the video, hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, share this with your friends, and if possible, hype this video. Thank you for watching and I'll see you later in the next one.